Hi, I'm David from Racom, and today I'm here to show you how to power up a RIPEX2 radio modem, access its admin web interface, and change settings. Please make sure you have your RIPEX2 unit, compatible power supply, Ethernet cable, a computer or mobile device, and optionally our USB to Wi-Fi or USB to Ethernet adapters ready. Now let's get started. First, connect the power supply. You can use any DC power supply rated for 10 to 30 volts. Connect it using the original power connector plug delivered with the RIPEX unit. Positive and negative pins are marked on the RIPEX unit. For permanent installation, don't forget to tighten the bolts to secure the connector in place. After connecting power, the unit will start booting up, and after a few seconds, the sysled turns green, indicating the unit is ready. Now you have two options. You can either connect to the unit directly or use an adapter. Direct connection can be achieved simply by connecting your computer to any Ethernet interface on the RIPEX unit. Please set IP on your computer to 192.168.169.250/24. And the RIPEX unit is then available on its default IP 192.168.169.169. Connection through an adapter is much more convenient, and we recommend it. To purchase USB to Ethernet and USB to Wi-Fi adapters, please contact us. Be aware that only Racom provided adapters are compatible with the unit due to the need for special firmware drivers. Here are both adapters. In this tutorial, I will be using my favorite USB to Wi-Fi mini dongle. To access RIPEX using Wi-Fi, simply plug the adapter to the USB port on the RIPEX unit and then connect your device to the newly available Wi-Fi network called RIPEX2 and its serial number. The network is available without a password by default. Your IP address will be automatically set via DHCP and the unit is available at 10, 9, 8 and 7. Make sure you are in a secure area when using unencrypted Wi-Fi. It is possible to activate Wi-Fi VPA2 PSK encryption later in the admin interface or turn off the Wi-Fi interface completely. If you prefer to use the USB to Ethernet adapter, the connection to the unit is the same. You just connect an Ethernet cable between the adapter and your computer. Now, launch your favorite web browser and navigate to the unit's IP address. It can be either 192.168.169.169 using direct connection, or 10, 9, 8, and 7 using an adapter. RIPEX web admin communication is protected using SSL encryption. Unfortunately, it is impossible to create security certificates that would be accepted when connecting directly to an IP address. That is why you need to accept security exception to access the web interface. To log in, simply type admin as both username and password and click the login button. RIPEX comes with a fully responsive web interface, which is easy to use on both mobile and desktop devices. The top bar tells you to which unit you're connected and its IP address. It also allows you to use our remote access feature to manage another unit on the network over the radio channel using our proprietary, super efficient management protocol. In the middle, you always see the current page title, while the right-hand side features access through the changes page and notification center. You can force reload of the admin UI using the refresh button. And of course, it is possible to log out and change your password from the user menu. We urge you to always change admin username and password in production environments. On the left-hand side, you see unit time, and below this is the main menu. The menu features four top-level links: status, which is the page you see now. Settings, where you can set everything up. Diagnostics, featuring many maintenance tools, and Advanced, which allows access to all set points and experimental features. Let's try changing the unit name as an example in this tutorial. Navigate to Settings, Device, Unit. Change unit name field content to something new, like Test Unit. A changed item is marked in yellow. You may also notice that the Changes button in the top bar is also indicating one pending change. All changes you make during your configuration are collected in the browser and sent to the device manually when you wish. We can try that now. Click on the Changes button. A new page appears listing all changes. You may reset them to start over, download the configuration file, or send changes to the device. Destructive actions are always marked in red, while actions you most likely need are in dark blue to help you quickly orient yourself. Click on the Send Configuration to upload the changes to the device. Depending on the nature of changes, it is possible subsystems will need to reboot, so please be patient. The admin will notify you after the settings are successfully applied. As the last step, please log out of the unit using the user menu in the top bar to close the connection. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. If you have any questions, please reach out here in the comments or via our website racom.eu. We recommend you watch our radio parameters tutorial next to learn how to set the radio communications. As always, please like and subscribe to our channel. In case you wish to be notified about our new releases, also click the bell button. Thank you for watching and have a great day.